This video is intended to be a very brief overview of Chapter 1, Working with the Windows 8 Desktop. For detailed information, I encourage you to read the chapter. Chapter 1 starts with the basics and the fact that all computers need a software to communicate with the hardware in their computer. Most computers today are run by a Windows operating system, such as you see on my screen. In this course, we'll learn to use Windows 8 or 8.1. Although there are no major changes in how 8 to 8.1 works, there are a couple of things that were corrected because of user complaints that make it even better. Most of you will have 8.1, as that is the latest with the update last March, which was a free update. We also anticipate that Windows 9 will be published this next March. One big change in Windows 8 is that the way the user interacts with the computer does not rely as much on keyboarding as it once did. That's not to say that keyboarding has gone away completely, because it hasn't. We now mostly rely on a mouse or touchpad or even touching the screen if you have that available as the most normal way for input. We now use a new term called gestures for these touch-enabled devices instead of relying on a separate input device. Other new terms that you may already be familiar with if you have a newer smartphone are swipe, slide, pinch, or stretch, and rotate. All these terms relate to touch-enabled devices. In Windows 8, you'll find that you have user accounts and local accounts. If you don't want to be connected to the cloud, then a local account is fine, which means that you don't have to log in. Being connected to the cloud means you're connected for storage, social media, and automatic syncing of calendars and settings, etc. On my screen, you'll note that I am connected to Microsoft account, as my profile shows in the top right. It also shows my picture because that's in my profile. If you want to be able to use cloud storage to access your data from anywhere, then you'll want to use your Microsoft account to log in. You'll need a Hotmail or Live account to log in. Once you've logged in, you will come to the Start screen. We had a Start button on the last few Windows operating systems, but we now have a Start screen which also works as a search screen. You can immediately start typing if you want to do a quick search without having to click on anything to get started. This screen is set up as tiles for easy viewing and touching. They can be moved around and organized by types of apps, files, or pages that you have created shortcuts for. On my screen, I have my tiles categorized or organized as in Most Used, Microsoft Software, and if I scroll over, then you can see my Adobe software because I have a subscription to that and use the Adobe software quite often, and then other entertainment apps that I have downloaded. I also have one for school stuff. But the most used apps are the ones that you see first. Also, some of these tiles are live. Notice they keep updating. Like right now, I have some music playing. The travel app keeps updating. You can right-click on them and turn the live tile off so that they are not constantly updating. If you have a limited amount of internet usage at home, then you probably want to turn them off. Take some time to explore some of the more common apps on the Start screen that you think you'll use most often. Without training, most users tend to go directly to the desktop, which is fine too. We finally have a use for the Windows button. This works as a toggle to easily move from Start screen to desktop. The Windows button can be found on your keyboard to the left of the Alt key, and also you can click on Desktop to quickly toggle the desktop tile to quickly toggle back to. Charms are hidden icons that help you access key system tools. The charms are on the right side of your screen. You can't see them until you've done something. Some of the charms that you'll use are the most or search, start, and settings. You can get to them by swiping in with your fingers if you have a touch screen, or hovering your mouse over the bottom right. You can also get to them with the shortcut Windows C. And there are the charms: Search, Share, Start, Devices, and Settings. Settings being the one you'll probably use quite a bit, where you can change the volume, you can check your internet connection, notifications, power, shut it down, in other words, control panel, and also your personalization. This was one of the biggest changes in 8.1, from 8 to 8.1, is at the top right. You kind of know that you have 8.1. If you look at the top right of your screen, you'll see that you have a power button and also the search button. Those two things, they wanted, most people wanted not to have to go to the charms, but they wanted them to display immediately on their screen. So this was a big change from 8 to 8.1. Also a good way to tell if you have 8.1 installed on your computer. Using the taskbar at the bottom displays buttons for each task. You will see the File Explorer and each button for active tasks. You can pin items that you use frequently to the taskbar, such as the snipping tool, which I have pinned. At the far right, there is a notification area that gives you important messages. You have a Show More button where you can see even more, but if you have solved PC problems or a printer problem, it will show you in this notification area. Another new term is a jump list. This is a term that refers to those documents you've recently opened or common commands you use. Peek allows you to preview an item by simply hovering your mouse over. If I hover my mouse over the Word on my taskbar, I will see a thumbnail, which allows me to see which file I want to open without actually opening it. In this chapter, you will also cover working with ribbons, minimizing, maximizing, moving, restoring, and resizing windows. These are terms that you may be familiar with if you've been using another Windows program, such as Windows 7. One big controversy with Windows 8 was the fact that there was no close button on the apps. This bothered users. You could close the apps with special combination keys. They stayed hidden so that if you use them again, they'd already be there. In Windows 8.1, the close button for apps was added back to the top right of the window. So, for instance, if I open the app Music, you'll see a close button now, another indicator that you have 8.1, and also it includes the minimize button. In another video, I'll discuss how to create screenshots and turn in your assignments for the chapter. End of chapter 1 video.